Hi everyone. In this video, we'll interpret the lingo solution and perform some sensitivity analysis. First, let's interpret the optimal solution. This is the lingo solution report we got in the previous video. The solution report tells us that a globally optimal solution of $7,668 was found. That means no feasible solution exists with a better objective values. $7,668 is the maximum profit that the company can get. Total infeasibilities are equal to zero, meaning no constraints or variable bounds were violated. Again, we see that Lingo took two iterations to solve the model. We also see the information of the model, such as two variables, five constraints, and 10 non-zeros as before. An important solution is the values of the decision variables. The quantities of standard and deluxe bags to produce are 540 and 252 respectively. This is the optimal value for the decision we need to determine. Next, we need to look at reduced cost. You will find a reduced cost figure for each variable. We might interpret reduced cost as the amount that the objective coefficients of the variable would have to improve before it would become profitable, to give the variable in question a positive value in the optimal solution. For example, if a variable had a reduced cost of 10, the objective coefficient of that variable would have to increase by 10 units in a maximization problem and/or decrease by 10 units in a minimization problem for the variable to become an attractive alternative to enter into the solution. A variable in the optimal solution, as in the case of standard or deluxe bags, automatically has a reduced cost of zero. In addition, the reduced cost may be interpreted as the amount of penalty you would have to pay to introduce one unit of that variable into the solution. Again, if you have a variable with a reduced cost of 10, you would have to pay a penalty of 10 units to introduce a variable into the solution. In other words, objective value would fall by 10 units in a maximization model or increase by 10 units in a minimization model. Next, the slack or surplus column in a Lingo solution report tells you how close you are to satisfying a constraint as an equality. This quantity on less than or equal to constraints is generally referred to as slack. On greater than or equal to constraints, this quantity is called a surplus. If a constraint is exactly satisfied as an equality, the slack or surplus value will be zero. If a constraint is violated, as in an infeasible solution, the slack or surplus value will be negative. Knowing this can help you find the violated constraints in an infeasible model, a model for which there doesn't exist a set of variable values that simultaneously satisfies all constraints. Non-binding constraints, constraints with a slack or surplus value greater than zero, will have positive non-zero values in this column. In our example, note that row 3 sewing operation had a slack of 120. That means the sewing department has 120 hours of slack or unused capacity. Similarly, the inspection and packaging department has 18 hours of slack or unused capacity. Next, let's perform some sensitivity analysis. Sensitivity analysis is a study of how the changes in the coefficients of an optimization model affect the optimal solution. Using sensitivity analysis, we can answer questions such as, how will a change in the coefficient of the objective function affect the optimal solution? How will a change in the right-hand side value of a constraint affect the optimal solution? Because sensitivity analysis is concerned with how these changes affect the optimal solution, the analysis does not begin until the ultimate solution to the original linear programming problem has been obtained. For that reason, sensitivity analysis is often referred to as post-optimality analysis. Sensitivity analysis is important to decision makers because real-world problems exist in a changing environment. Prices of raw materials change, product demand changes, companies purchase new machinery, stock prices fluctuate, employees' turnover occurs, and so on. If a linear programming model has been used in such environment, we can expect some of the parameters to change over time. We will then want to determine how these changes affect the optimal solution to the original linear programming model. Sensitivity analysis provides us with the information needed to respond to such changes without requiring the complete solution of a revised linear program. The Lingo solution report gives a dual price figure for each constraint. We can interpret the dual price as the amount that the objective would improve as the right-hand side, a constant term of the constraint, is increased by 1 unit. For example, in our case, the dual price of 4.375 on row 2 means adding 1 more hour of cutting and dyeing operation would cause the profit to improve by $4.375 to a value of 7668 plus 4.375 or 7672.375. Similarly, the dual price of 6.94 on row 4 means adding 1 more hour of finishing time would improve the profit by $6.4 to a value of 7668 plus 6.4 or $7,674.94. Since the sewing and the inspection and packaging constraints both have slack or unused capacity available, the dual values of 0 show that additional hours of these operations will not improve the total profit. Notice that improve is a relative term. In a maximization problem, improve means the objective value would increase. However, in a minimization problem, the objective value would decrease if you were to increase the right-hand side of a constraint with a positive dual price. Dual prices are sometimes called shadow prices because they tell you how much you should be willing to pay for additional units of a resource. This is a term used in Excel solver. In our example, we can interpret that the company should be willing to pay up to $4.375 for each additional hour of cutting and dyeing operation. Next, the Lingo solution report also provides ranges for the objective function coefficients and the right-hand sides of the constraints. If we look at the objective function coefficient range analysis, we see that variable S, which has a current profit contribution of 10, has an allowable increase of 3.5 and an allowable decrease of 3.7. Therefore, as long as the profit contribution associated with the standard bag is between $10 minus $3.7 or $6.3 and 10 plus 3.5 or $13.5, the solution of S equals 540 standard bags and D equals 252 deluxe bags will remain the optimal solution. Therefore, the range of optimality for the objective function coefficients on variable S is from 6.3 to 13.5. Similarly, the range of optimality on variable D is from 9 minus 2.33 or $6.67 to 9 plus 5.29 or $14.29. Thus, we can make this conclusion about the optimal solution without solving the revised model. The final section of the Lingo solution report provides the allowable increase and allowable decrease in the right-hand side, the constraints relative to the dual values holding. As long as the constraint right-hand side is not increased or decreased, by more than the allowable increase or decrease, the associated dual price gives the exact change in the value of the optimal solution per unit increase in the right-hand side. For example, let's consider the cutting and dyeing constraint with the current right-hand side value of 630. Because the dual value for this constraint is $4.37, we can conclude that additional hours will increase objective function by $4.37 per hour. It is also true that a reduction in the hours available will reduce the value of the objective function by $4.37 per hour. From the range information given, we see that the dual value of $4.37 has an allowable increase of 52.36 and is therefore valid for right-hand side values up to 630 plus 52.36 or 682.36. The allowable decrease is 134.4. So the dual value of $4.37 is valid for the right-hand side values down to 630 minus 134.4, which equal to 495.6. And we can make the same interpretation for the remaining constraints. Basically, as long as the values of the right-hand side are within these ranges, the dual values shown on the report will not change. Right-hand side values outside these limits will result in changes in the dual value information. In this case, we need to solve the revised model. We may ask why we care about resolving the revised model. There are two reasons. First, for the sensitivity analysis purpose, we can use this approach to develop multiple what-if scenarios based on the same solution report. Thus, the decision maker can see how any changes in the parameters might affect the objective and the optimal solution. Second, complex models might require much more time to solve. Note that as the number of variables and number of constraints increase, the solving time will increase exponentially. I've seen some complex optimizers models require 10 to 20 hours of a powerful computer to find the optimal solution. So it is not always practical to resolve the model again whenever we make changes in the parameters. Of course, when the changes are outside of allowable ranges, we have to rerun the model with new parameters. That is how to interpret the optimal solution and perform sensitivity analysis. Thank you, and bye now.